Oh yeah, Dane's going to be knocking up a really nice, simple white chocolate sponge pudding, and we're going to have a really nice gooey center to that, and we're going to cheat because fondant cakes are lovely, but they're a bit difficult thing to do. So what we're going to do, we're going to make a nice, like soft white chocolate middle, which is going to be a ganache, and put it in the middle of the cake, and then when we cook it, and it'll come out, it'll be a delightful chocolatey, liquidy, white chocolate deliciousness in the middle. So we've got 125 grams of plain white chocolate. I've got chocolate buttons, and these are going to be really good for melting down. If you've got chocolate, white chocolate bar, same amount of chocolate, but just make sure you've chopped it up nice and fine so that when you're going to melt it in a minute, that'll melt much quicker than to wait around for a big bar of chocolate to melt. We've also got 150 millilitres of double cream here, which we're going to bring to the boil in this thick bottom pan, and then we're going to stir it little by little into this white chocolate so the chocolate melts into the cream, and then we're going to keep stirring it until it cools down, and that's going to form a really nice sort of thick white chocolate ganache instead, and then we can put that in the middle of our cake before we cook it. Brilliant. Okay, so that's just starting to simmer nicely, so we're going to turn that off. Basically, that's going to go get mixed into our white chocolate now, and we're going to keep mixing that until it cools and all the white chocolate's melted. We've got a really nice, thick, creamy, chocolatey mixture, and that's going to be the centre of our cake. So we're just going to pull this in straight into our white chocolate. I'm going to put about half in first, put the other half down for a couple of minutes. Well, first of all, we just want to get the chocolate really melted. It's quite a nice warm day, so the chocolate's quite soft already. If you're doing this on a cold wintry day and the chocolate's hard and it's cold, whatever, you could melt this chocolate, just break that up into a bowl, put it over a saucepan of boiling water for a few minutes, and that'll get it nice and soft, basically, to begin with. As you can see, this is really melted down very quickly, the chocolate nibs down, and it's really starting to come together quite nicely. So I'm going to just stir in the rest of that cream now that's come together, and I'm going to stir it as it cools. So you can see that's all come together really nicely. There's no obvious big lumps of chocolate, so the chocolate's all melted. So it's going to keep stirring that for a couple of minutes now, and then that can go in the fridge to cool down, ready for the next stage of our cake. Okay, so for the sponge element of our chocolate cake, I've got 150 grams of unsalted butter, which has been softening for a while. I've got 100 grams of white sugar, so caster sugar in there. Probably normally would use 150 grams if you're making a sponge, 150 grams of sugar to go with the 150 grams of butter. White chocolate's quite sweet, so we don't actually need as much sweetness from the sugar for this. But what I'm going to do is put that in the mixer. We're going to give it a good beat up with the cake mixing attachment. And while that's doing, I'm going to get 175 grams of cell raising flour with 1 teaspoon of baking powder in there. And I'm going to grab myself 2 eggs. So I'm going to get that on, and then we'll come back and we'll see where we are. Okay, so that's had a really, really good mix now. It's all light and fluffy and lovely. So I've grabbed my cell raising flour, 175 grams of cell raising flour there. Got my 2 eggs. I've also grabbed 100 grams of white chocolate, and I'll grab myself a muffin tin here, which I'm going to butter ready for these to go in there in a minute. I've also turned my oven on 160 on a gas mark on a fan oven. It's about gas mark 4, probably 180 in any normal electric oven. Okay, so we're going to first see what we're doing. I'm going to crack both my eggs into this mix, and then give it another 2 minutes or so with the mixer, and then I'm going to start putting my white flour, double raisin flour, baking powder, in a spoon at a time. Basically, it's going to come together into a really nice kind of thick cake batter. I'm going to add my white chocolate again into that, and then we can start putting these cakes together, ready for cooking. So my butter, sugar, and my eggs are really nicely combined here, really nice, thick, creamy looking mixture. So I'm going to start adding my self-raising flour to this, put it on a medium speed, get that really stirred in, get it into this nice thick cake batter that we need. It's looking really nice and thick now, nice fluffy mix there. So we're going to just stir in our white chocolate, and then we're going to start getting this into our case ready for cooking. Okay, good. So I've got my cake mix, got my cake batter here. It's very nice, fluffy and lovely, ready to go. And I put my ganache here, which has really started to thicken up nicely. So that's perfect. Now, absolutely everything, just what we need. So we're going to take a good spoonful of our cake mix and put it at the bottom of each of our muffin tins. I'm going to push it in. So we've got a good sort of filled to the level here with our muffin tins with our cake mix. And indeed, we're going to take 2 teaspoons here. So we're going to get 2 teaspoons. We're just going to put a nice, good sized blob of our Grenache right in the middle of our mix like that. That's going to go back in the fridge. That'll keep for a week, so they can use that for anything you want. I'm going to obviously make into the rest of my cakes here. But if you've got any left over, you can keep hold of that. Really nice with some fruit or whatever, so that's really good. What we're going to do now is top these up. So we're going to make a dome of our cake mix over the top of those so that the ganache is completely encased within the cake dough. So got all of these, got the ganache encased in the the cake dough here, and it's ready to go in the oven. I'm going to give these pour an hour in this oven.
So here we are, this is our delicious chocolate sponge with the gooey chocolate ganache on the outside of it here. So the sponge is all cooked nicely. It's a give or take 15 minutes in the oven. And the ganache is turned into a nice gooey liquidy center and started to ooze out of the cake. So I'm just going to have to have a bit of cream and some nice fruit here. And that's delicious. About half an hour start to finish. It's a really nice, simple little treat for you.